Good morning to one and all. Today we are going to discuss about the, in continuation with the yesterday's topic, we are going to discuss human health and diseases. In this human health and diseases topic, till now we have discussed related to the different types of physical barriers, physiological barriers, cellular barriers, cytokinal barriers, and coming on to the next one, we also discuss the acquired or specific immunity, also in the different types and the structure of antibody. Now we are going to today discuss about the two different types of immunities or under humoral immunity. So already we know that humoral immunity is of two types. One is called antibody mediated immunity. That is AMI, antibody mediated immunity. The second one is cellular mediated immunity, CMI. Here antibody mediated immunity is antibody, and this is determined by B lymphocytes. B lymphocytes. Cellular based immunity is initiated by T lymphocyte. The T lymphocyte is either produced by thymus or thymus gland, and B lymphocyte is by bone marrow, and these lymphocytes are present in the blood only. So antibodies are present in blood. Whenever the blood activated immunity is there, blood initiated immunity, blood initiated immunity is called humoral immunity. Blood initiated immunity is called humoral immunity, and humoral immunity is of two types: antibody mediated immunity and cellular mediated immunity. And cellular immunity is initiated by T lymphocytes. Antibody mediated immunity is by B lymphocytes. And T lymphocytes are of three types. T lymphocytes are of three types: suppressor, killer, and helper. So they are in with the TS, TK, they are renamed with these naming conventions: TH. And so remember the name Shahrukh Khan, SHK. Shahrukh Khan for identifying the T lymphocytes. So here how they are useful: antibody mediated immunity, or this cell mediated immunity are generally useful in so if anything is initiated by B lymphocytes, that is antibody production, that is called as antibody mediated immunity and cell. So how these are useful? So whenever a foreign material like pathogen means disease causing microorganism enter into our body or which does not belong to our body, this will be acted by first B lymphocyte. So this B lymphocytes produces a protein called antibody. So B lymphocytes directly does not fight the foreign material, but it will fight with the help of a protein fighting or resisting, also called as resisting fight. The protein is called antibody that will fight. So to support this B lymphocyte, T lymphocyte, T lymphocyte either produces suppressor cells or helper cells or killer cells. Any one will be produced that will be supporting this. So the suppressor cell will suppress the immune response, and helper cell will help the B lymphocytes, and killer cell will support the B lymphocyte in antibody-antigen reaction by killing the phagocytosis. So here these are useful for phagocytosis. So how these are useful generally when we try to understand? So here, so hope you understood this once. Have a look. Now, how these antibody mediated immunity or cell mediated immunity are responsible? So, certain times you will be listening about the words liver transplantation, kidney transplantation, skin transplantation, hair transplantation and heart transplantation. These are the terms we generally see when these organs are damaged, means here we need to understand two things. One is called donor, means gives organs. Donor means who gives the organs. Recipient, you already learned these terms in the chapter 18th of first PUC. First PUC, antigen and antibody. Blood, you have learned these terms. So recipient takes or not. There we have learned one term. Donors and agent always reacts with acceptor's antibody. If any mismatch between these two, patient dies. If no mismatch, patients survive. This we have discussed already in the chapter 18, first PUC only. Now, I don't know how many has remembered that, but we have discussed these points. Now, coming on to the tissue or blood or grafts. Grafts means nothing but transplantation. When these are going on, so they will check for donors same for, so all the blood group, the tissue and the recipients are same. Not if they are not same, patients body, patient's body rejects the organs or grafting is failed. Grafting is failed. So in this particular case, so you can see that the reactions take place. So in the case of once the grafting has happened, grafting is completed. In order to overcome, already we have discussed the MHC, major histocompatibility type 2 reaction. To overcome this type 2 reaction, he has to use immunosuppressants throughout life. So the person who has been grafting, so he will develop a reaction called major histocompatibility reaction, type 2 reaction, and he need to use in his lifetime throughout the life. Once the grafting is completed, the immunosuppressants, because body identifies self organs, okay, other organs that is grafted, tries to reject. So this antibody mediated immunity versus cell mediated immunity, if it is the same, it is accepted. If it is not, other organs generally tries to reject. For that reason, when they are grafted, they need to take the immunosuppressants throughout the life in order to sustain that graft rejection or the capability. Next one, immunity. Immunity means overall ability of host body to resist or fight against pathogen, antigen or toxin is called immunity. The overall ability of a host body to resist or fight against the pathogens, whether it is an antigen or the toxin of that, is called as an immunity. So, in the immunity, already we have discussed that what is antibody mediated immunity and cellular. Antibody mediated immunity means immunity which is activated by B lymphocytes and where the antibody is produced against antigen, and as a result of that, the immunity, whatever the person develops immunity, is called as antibody mediated immunity. And the second type is cell mediated immunity, or cytotoxic killer cells are produced by the T lymphocytes, and they will be acting on the, either they will be supporting the immunity of the by antibody, or else they will also support in killing the phagocytosis of the cells. Generally, in the case of cancer cells, we can see this immunity. So, antibody mediated immunity and cell mediated immunity, these two are the types of humoral immunity. Humoral immunity. Now, we will try to understand the next part called as active immunity. What is active immunity and what is passive immunity? Active means antigen. When reacting with antibody, the immunity developed. Immunity developed by host means man or any organism. That antibody developed by the host, that type of thing. An antigen is released by the pathogen, that in concert to the antibody is produced by the host, and it itself fight. The fighting between the antigen and antibody fight, whenever the antibody comes, takes control of the antigen and destroys the antigen, that type of immunity which is produced by the bodies of the host is called as antibody mediated, active immunity. Means here the immunity is actively produced by host, and generally it is